What's up and welcome back. I'm John Stark from MacMovieGuy.com, your favorite blind film critic. And today I'm doing a pilot review because they only released the one episode. It is Emperor of Ocean Park. This is an MGM Plus show and it has audio description. If you subscribe to MGM Plus as a Prime Channel add-on, if you are trying to use the app, then no. To my knowledge, it has no integration on the app. However, if you subscribe to MGM Plus, I'm mentioning this today because I know there are Prime Channel deals for Prime Day. So for the three people who will watch this, congratulations. You've been told that there are shows on MGM Plus that have audio description. There are even movies on MGM Plus that have audio description. But you have to do it as a Prime Channel add-on. Amazon is being a little bitch. So, sorry about that. I'm a blind film critic, so I like to introduce myself at the top visually for people. I've got a black baseball cap on backwards. I've got my black sunglasses on. And this is why I haven't done this usually, because I don't always know what shirt I'm wearing. I think this is a Mario Kart racing shirt. Not 100% sure, but I believe that's the one I'm wearing. So we'll go with that. I have another shirt that kind of has, I feel the, like the shapes and everything of it. Sometimes like recognition and AI tools aren't always best with graphic tees. I think this is Mario Kart. Emperor of Ocean Park is Forrest Whitaker's new show for MGM Plus. Obviously, he had a successful run doing Godfather of Harlem. So I'm sure MGM Plus is hoping to bring people in for this. Honestly, I thought this was kind of slow and kind of boring. Kind of feels like it wants to be Succession. It's not Succession. And instead, it's just, I don't know, something else. It takes place, it's based on a novel, and there's a conservative judge played by Forrest Whitaker, who it's suggested used to be sort of like the future of the Republican Party in terms of the conservative movement of the Republican, whatever, that side of it. And then he started watching too much cable news. And became kind of like radicalized and lost his train of thought, and the stuff he was pushing for, just, you know, all that kind of stuff. And then now he's dead. So, sorry, spoiler alert, but the pilot episode is about his death and his children coming together to rally around him. However, the show is heavily reliant upon flashbacks. So if you came for Forrest Whitaker, it is very likely you will get lots of Forrest Whitaker in flashbacks. So he'll be here. But sort of the series star, I think, is probably Grantham Coleman, who plays one of his sons, who's a law professor. And he kind of comes into this, he was sort of enjoying his peaceful life away from his father and away from this sort of nonsense. Obviously, his career choice inspired by his father, but you get kind of the idea that his kids were, which is why I compared it to Succession. It's like, yeah, those kids, you know, they circled around their father, but at times they were often at odds with their father. So it's that very complicated relationship. And I think instead of seeing it playing out in real time, like we did on Succession, we'll see it play out in flashbacks. So it's just really slow. There's like a mystery here to his death, and the show ends with this guy kind of coming up to Grantham Coleman and being like, "Tell me his plan! Tell me his plan!" And I was just like, oh my god. it's a bit over the top, sir. I honestly don't know most of this cast. I couldn't even really place Grantham Coleman. I just managed to learn the series star name. I looked through the supporting cast. I was like, oh, Brian Greenberg's in this. Okay. He always has like a special place in my heart as a TV watcher because I really adored the show October Road. He also did How to Make It in America. He was the lead in that. He's not a star. It's okay if you don't know who he is. He just had a couple TV shows. But yeah, if you're an October Road fan, short-lived drama on ABC, then you'll know who I'm talking about. I don't know where he is in this. I don't know. It's an ensemble drama, and it was really slow, and I was fighting the urge to like keep going. I don't know that I'm gonna watch more than one episode of this. It was really slow. A couple of weeks ago, I reviewed Orphan Black Echoes, which didn't have audio description on AMC Plus, and I was like, I don't think I'm gonna recap this. I really love Kristen Ritter, but I don't know how long I'm gonna go with the show. Two episodes. I watched the first two episodes, and then I gave up. So I didn't really get anything out of the first episode. I didn't really get a clear vision for the future of the show. I didn't really get strong characters. I got a mystery. I got like, ooh, there's something to behold if you stay with us long enough. And I'm like, yeah, but like for 10 episodes? I mean, like, yeah, Forest Whitaker is a good actor, but like he's a good actor in other things that I can watch him in. You know, I think that's the mistake we make sometimes is like, oh, well, they're a good actor. And it's like, yeah, it's a good actor and it attracted me to the pilot, which I watched. But just because someone's a good actor doesn't mean I need to watch the entirety of their body of work because some of the stuff isn't good. Some people sign on to bad things. I don't see myself going another episode into this show, although I do find it interesting that MGM Plus is really trying to make more of a concerted effort to put audio description on their shows. Amazon is pushing that. I know there are a couple other shows that I've heard have audio description. I just haven't watched them yet. Mainly because they're already in their like second or third season, and it's like I have to go back to season one. Like Beacon 12 has audio description, but I think that's in its second season. It's like that's a big commitment to catch up to that for a show that I don't even really know what it's about. MGM Plus is sort of like off the radar for me, but I'm trying to put it on the radar because I do have it as a Prime Channel add-on. And I use it mostly for movies, admittedly. This is a really weird review of this pilot, I will admit that. But they do have, they're probably one of the better services that challenges the conception of TCM in terms that they have a whole bunch of MGM's catalog titles, classics, you know, classic films. So that's what they're really good for. And some of them have actually have audio description. So, this is it feels like it wants to be Succession, and what they did is they changed the game, and they're like, but what if Logan Roy had been dead the whole time, and then his children had to figure out life? Well, already these kids seem more normal and well-adjusted than any of the kids in the Succession cast, which kind of makes the series a little bit more boring. Part of the reason why Succession worked so well was that the kids were also like hot garbage and nobody really wanted any of them. Like I kept sitting there going, who should succeed? Everybody's got problems, you know. Logan Roy kind of broke all of his kids. So here you kind of feel like, well, we didn't really like our dad. I don't know. I just feel like it could have had a different pulse to the show, a different beat. I know slow burns are a thing, but they're really hard to pull off in TV shows because you have to get people in on the pilot or they can turn it off. Slow burns work more in movies, generally because people have like traveled to the theater and they're less likely to just walk out. So a slow burn movie will work because that, and then you'll get the word of mouth and people will tell you, oh, it's a great slow burn, which means it'll pick up the pace as the movie goes along, wait till the ending. You know what I'm saying? Like that kind of thing. It's like, oh man, it was really good, but yeah, it's a little slow for you. But with a TV show, it's so risky to do that because I can just not watch the next episode. There's nothing forcing me to do that. And in a show whose format is being released weekly, there's a huge chance that I don't even have the option of just letting my, service keep running, and just like, well, it'll play the next episode. It can't play the next episode because you only premiered one. So, when you're doing it in these kind of formats, it really matters. You kind of have to hit hard and hit fast. And this kind of hits slow, and it's okay. I mean, the acting's fine. Like, the pacing of the show and just me going, like, why does this show exist? Was sort of the question. There's going to be like a mystery around his death, but there are so many shows about mysteries around somebody's death. It's like, but why your show? And if you're going to point to Forrest Whitaker and be like, well, he's the reason. Honestly, after one episode of this, I can tell you he's been better in other things. He's portraying somebody who's really old in this. That's what he's doing right now. So I got nothing on this, really. If you stay with it, stay with it. Audio description wise, I was pleasantly surprised. I thought it was really good audio description, but I say this routinely, rue fucking teenly. I say this all the time in the industry. Damn you people. The shows with predominantly black cast typically have better audio description than shows with predominantly white cast. Because for some reason, shows with predominantly black casts are more prone to describing their cast members than shows with predominantly white casts. So we get more of who someone is, what do they look like, because generally a show has some sort of racial connotation to it, in so much that it matters whether or not somebody is black or white in this show. So they let you know. In other shows, casting is all about representation, and somebody has determined that it doesn't really matter, and therefore, we don't need to know. But it's something that sighted people get to see. It's something that sighted adults and sighted kids get to see the representation on screen, which is why it's important for it to be in the audio description, regardless of whether or not there is any sort of racial undertone in the show, whether or not that exists at all. So, yeah, it is a well-described show. I have no idea who did it because this show had like no credits. I got like, I've never seen a show end quicker than this. I don't know what MGM Plus does with shows. I honestly have not. This is the first one I've actually like completed, I think, like from beginning to ending, because again, very low amount of audio description. But damn, I got like, and then it tried to push me into something else. I was like, what the fuck is this show? Show didn't have audio description either. I actually thought it was another episode. I thought it was doing that thing where it was like playing multiple episodes. And I was like, no, that's a different show. What is this? Why doesn't it have audio description? What the fuck is going on? Anyway, that's neither here nor there. I can't really. I can't say that this is the best show and that you should watch this. I think if somebody sticks with this and they watch all 10 episodes and they get to the 10th episode and they're just like, oh my God, that was an experience. Maybe then I'll go back and watch it. But as it stands, this was boring. I'm gonna give Emperor of Ocean Park, I'm gonna give it like a C minus. I was really bored by it. It's the acting is fine. But that's about it. It sounds like it's got maybe something, like a mystery, but just because it sounds like you have a mystery doesn't mean you know what to do with it. And there's not enough in the pilot to make me believe that this show knows what to do with its mystery. So, anyway, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and I'll see you guys on the other side.